Okay. At the beginning of the class today, we have already talked about the data structure union, the data structure, right? We call struct. And in C programming, we also have another kind of the data structure. That is a we can call it as a flexible data structure that we call is the name is union. The name is union, right? What does it mean by the union? Union is similar to the case of struct, right? But a union is also a derived data class, a data type like structure with member that share the same storage space. Okay, we have to highlight here, right? With member that share the same storage space. For example, we can define the definition of the union similarly to the structure definition. Okay, so we can start from union, right? Normally when you use struct, right, you use struct. This is the abbreviation of the structure. But for union, we use union, and then number will be the name of this data type. I have to name this data type. Normally, in convention again, right? Normally we have to, okay, that doesn't matter. Okay, so, and then this one will be integer, this one will be double. But for union, only difference between union and structure is this, right? For union, it is a or, right? You can access to either integer X or double Y. For the case of structure, you should define structure num 2, right? And you declare it as int X and double Y, right? Both X and Y will be shown. Okay, X and Y will be shown. But for the union, integer X or double Y will be shown only. Okay, so it means that indicate the number of union type with member integer X, or actually we have to use or double Y. Okay, what does it mean by this? You can define a union with many members, but only one member can contain a value at any given time. At any given time. Okay, so the best way to understand the union characteristic, I will show you the how to write the program using union. But before we go to the part of writing program, right, I would like to conclusion here that the union provide an efficient way of using the same memory location for different or multiple purpose. Okay, I will show like this. A good example of the union is like this. Suppose I have a union geometry. Suppose in your domain, you have two geometries. The first one will be geometry of circle and square and rectangular. So circle or square or rectangle, they are all geometry, a kind of geometry object. But at a time, right, it this as a given geometry will be circle, or will be a property of square, or will be a rectangular. Only one geometry at a time. So at any given time, right, Only one member can contain value at any given time. So in this way, we are going to say that this geometry will share the same memory location for multiple purpose. Multiple purpose mean it could be circle, it could be square, or it could be rectangle. Do you get the point? If you don't get the point, I will try to write to show you the program now. Okay, let me write open. Okay, first we have to start from standard.io and stream.h, right? And I define a new data structure union, right? In data, right? Data. And inside the data, we have to use in I or for f or character string, okay? There are three different data type: integer, floating point, or real number, and a string, right? In this case, union, we have to use this particular memory location. We have to allocate the memory space, right, according to the maximum size of this data type: integer, float, and character.
Did you hear me? Okay. Okay, so now I declare like this, right? And then I try to copy the program, right? So integer main. So, and in main program, right? I declare a new data type, union data, data, right? Union data will be this is a type name, right? Union data, and data will be the available of the type union data. And then what will be the size of this union data? Because you can use the same memory location, but it could store only integer sometimes, or store floating sometimes, or character sometimes. For I, right, normally I is the size of I is 4 bytes, am I right? And the size of float, if you could remember, the size of the floating point will be 4 bytes as well. But what is the size of array of character? 20 array of character, 20 characters. What is the size? 20 bytes, right? 20 bytes. So here I'm trying to print out memory size occupied by data, right? And I use size of data. We have declare variable data of data structure union data. Right. I'm going to show you what is the size of the union data, capital data, right? It supposed to print out 20, okay, and I run. Size of any size of is in standard library or not? I'm not sure. Oh, it's a long unsigned integer. Okay, maybe we have to use LD longly. Okay. Okay, memory size occupied by data is 20. So in this way, right, normally if we change these two struct, okay, the size will be the addition of the size of I float and struct and an array of character, 20 characters, right? So when we run the program, the size of, if I use struct, okay, if I use struct first, when it runs, the size will be 28, 20 plus 4 plus 4, right? This is the size of the data, right? So I is visible, F is visible, and structure and thing here is visible, also visible. But if we change to union, right? We have to select or at a specific time in the future, we will have to use either of this, right? Only one of this data type, but because this one is the biggest size that you have to sort, so the maximum size of the data here will be the maximum size of one attribute here, that is the 20. So that's why when we use union, the size will be 20, that is the maximum. Okay, do you understand the point? Okay. And then how to access into the memory or into the union members. Okay, we can do the same thing, right? Okay, I use, okay, for main, right? Integer main, we have changed it to, okay, for the union data, right? And we set up data to data.i to 10, data.f to 220.5, and then copy string to C programming. Okay, I try to print out each value. Actually, we cannot print each value. Why? At a specific time, right? Only one data will be printed out correctly. Okay, so even we try to assign 10 to I and F of floating point by this one, and this one will be copied. So when I run this program, okay, can you see the result? Data I is this value, data.f is this value, and only data.string is equal to C programming. Only the last one is correct. Do you know the reason why when we print out data.string, only the last line is correct? Can you tell me the reason? Can you tell me the reason? It is assigned instead of I and F. Is it because of sync copy? Almost correct. Okay, I have told you that for the union, right, they will share the same memory, but only it can only store the value at a particular time. Yes, because of the union. But I ask you why. To access any member of union, we use the dot notation, right? But the member access operator is coded as a period of time between the union variable name and the union member, right, that we wish to access. That's right, Natcha. It is because it is the last value assigned. In this way, in this program, right, you will see that I has been assigned first, and then floating point has been assigned the second. But we assign the data structures, the string, the last one. So now the value that put inside the data, you did the union data, is the value of the C programming only. So if we try to print out the data.i, which is the integer value, if you try to print out the value of the first, then we try to map the C programming, or we can say casting C programming into 10. Oh no, sorry. Trying to cast the type of the C programming, which is a string, into the integer, and then try to print out the integer. Data.i to think about the C programming as an integer. And the second line, it will also think about the C programming as a floating point, and then they will try to print out the floating point of the C programming. So this one is but we cannot know whether it is correct or not. But when we try to print out the string, which is the last assignment or the last initialization, we have to say the last assignment of the data, union data, like with C programming. So this way, when you try to print out data.string, right, the result will be correct. The C programming will be printed out because the data, the union data, has been assigned C programming, the last one. Okay, this is the meaning of how to use the union. Do you understand my point? Do you get the point? So what does it mean by union? Union means it is a data structure in C programming, but you have to use one of this line, one of this data type, right? But the last assignment to a particular attribute will be the correct result, or the right value that stored in that union data. Okay. So in order to make this program correct, you have to write to printf each data in sequence. For example, you may have to write a program like this. Integer main. Okay, integer main, right? And then, okay, when you assign data as integer and then print out integer, assign float, and then assign string, right? Then we run. Okay, you can see that the data now is printed out correctly. Wait for a while. Okay, now you can see that the program is printed out correctly. Right, because we assign the data integer, right, and then print out, and then assign as a floating point, and then print out. So it will print out right after the direct assignment. Okay. In the slide, I also give you the how to, in the page 33, right? I also give you the initialization of the union, right? If you initialize it in terms of the integer, it will assign the value to integer value. But if you initialize it in terms of the real number, it will be assigned into the double or floating point data structure. Okay, this is the page 33. And then this is also the union demonstration, right, in the page 34, right? You can try to type this one and try to see the result from this program, right? We have the union number, right, and number, you have to use either integer x or double y. Once again, right, the variable that you declare here, it cannot be duplicate or cannot be the same, right? If you declare in I, right, float f, you cannot define in I, float I, character I. No, you cannot. Even you can access to either of them, right? But you cannot name the same name. Okay? Okay, let me copy this to this one. Actually, you can also try to copy the code from my slide, right? I provide you to copy, right? You can mark the characters and then you copy and then you can put onto the compiler, right? You can do that. Okay, so it doesn't matter. So the next thing that is okay, I come back to slide. You can still hear me, right? Okay, here we are at the slide 35, right? What I have taught to you previously, right? This is the page 33, right? If you want to initialize a union value, right? If you initialize it as an integer, so it will be assigned to the integer. For this case, you assign it as a real number, right? It will be assigned to the double y, right? This is the how smart the C compiler is. And then you can try to write up this program, right? To demonstrating the union, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, so the next construct that you might have to know, that is an enumeration. Even you are the C programmers, right? Or if you are a senior C programmer, you might not have used the enumeration, but I would like to teach you because it is also an interesting structure or the data type as well. If you want to define a new data structure, you can also use the data struct or union. And if you want to define a new set of things, for example, if I want to I want to declare a set of months in a year, right? We have Jan, Feb, Mar, and so on, right? I want to define Jan as a zero and February, which is the second month of the year, and I would like to define it as one, right? So I use the concept of enumeration. Enumeration mean numerate, mean number, right? So enumerate mean to make it to be a number, right? Enumerate mean to make it to be a number. Or to be numbers. For example, in this case, if I use
enum, right? Month will be a new data type, right? Month will be a new data type, right? And start with the braces and end with braces. And then Jan, Feb, March, April, May, June, and so on, right? So if you can this way, right? Jan, which is the number, the first number will be assigned to zero automatically. If you didn't say anything, that J is equal to something, right? It will be initialized into zero by default. And what will be the value for Feb? Can you tell me? What is the value for Feb? What is the value for Feb? Ah, Santon, thank you. It's one. And how about March, MAR? Two, that's right. So in the program, right, you cannot declare a new variable name like Jan, Feb, like this. But common sense, right, you are not going to declare a new variable with all capitalized, with our character capitalized, that you are not going to do that, right? But you will do this for enumerate. This is why I asked you to, if you want to declare a variable, you have to start with small letter. For example, integer, extra b, right? You have to start with a small letter. If you want to define a structure, the name of structure, I suggest you to start with the capital, like this, like structure books. I start with capital. But in the enumeration, if you want to declare new variables, right, you have to make it all capitalized. Make it all capitalized to make it to be all understandable. It is. It's also the same as the consent. If you could remember, if I ask you to write the consent, right, you has to be all capitalized. For example, if I define max for 1,000, like, so max will be all capitalized. This is the same thing, right? Because this one will be actually in the real implementation. This one will be mapped to 11. This one will be mapped to 10 and so on, right? But if you think it doesn't make sense that you use Jan for zero, you want to make Jan to be one, right? So you can start Jan with one, and then Feb will be two, March will be three, and April will be four automatically. That's why we call enumeration. Enumeration will be to make your variable to be numerate, to be numerated, to make it to be a number. Okay, so this is the meaning of enumeration, and this is an example of enumeration. Okay, sometimes you want to write a program. Maybe you start with the month, Jan. I can also write month. Month is an enumerate, right? You can see that. When you want to define a new variable month to be months, right, data type enumerate months, right, and months. We can also use month as an integer. So we have to start, you can write a for loop. Month is equal to Jan until month is less than or equal to December. So when you write a program this way, right, it is readable. readable, right? It is very easy, right? It is readable, easy to read, right? Instead, you may have to, okay, if you don't have the enumeration, you have to write for loop. Month from 0 to month less than 12, and then month plus plus. If you like this, like it doesn't make any sense, right? The human being like us cannot understand about 0 or 12 at all. But even you are the programmer, you are the computer scientist or computer programmers, right? But it doesn't make sense. But if you write a month, it starts from Jan and then end up with the December, this makes sense, make more sense, right? So enumeration is not just the construct that just show and you didn't use it. But if you want to make the program to be readable, I suggest you to write a program like this. For another example, I also use the enumeration for months, right? Or I use for month or weekday, right? If I want to declare like Monday, I use day, right? As a Monday or Tuesday, right? When I can also use day plus plus, right? If my today is Monday, right? Day plus plus will be Tuesday, right? That is easy to write a program, right? And also I can also use this one for the traffic light. Start from red, green, no, not red, let it go. Red, and what? Start from green, right? And then to yellow, right? And then to red, right? And from red, the traffic light will go to green, right? Am I right? Okay, if you use this as a maybe green is 1, yellow is 2, and red is 3, right? And then when enumerate, also, when enumerate is 4, right, it will wrap around 2-1 again or 2-0 again. You have to manage about this one. So you can also use the enumeration green, yellow, and red to be the traffic light implementation for the traffic system. Okay, this is a good example. And this one, this example, right, we're trying to map from January, which is the defined it as a consent character month name, right? And we can also map to the enumeration 1, 2, 3, 4, right? Right, you can write percent sign D and percent sign S, right? And month can be starting from Jan, which is 1, right? And December is 12. And month name, we start with the now string. This one is now string. Right, this one will be index 0, but index 1 will be January, index 2 will be February, and March will be 3, and the last one will be 12. Something like this, and then we can also map from 1 to January, 10 to October, something like this. This one is the how to make use of the enumeration. Okay, so that's all for the enumeration. And the next thing is quite difficult. Okay, so if you understand today structure, union and enumeration, that's fine, right? But the next thing that I would like to show you is that it is about the linked list. I've already told you how to make use of the array, right? Array, you need it to be fixed number of element. If you know in advance that the number of the element that you are going to use, maybe you can use array. But just in case that you don't know the number of the elements, my suggestion is that is to use the linked list. Linked list is a good implementation of using pointer together with the structure, the data structure. Okay, we have to use limit like this. For example, if I have the number, right, or key, right, and I press or the score, right, the score of the student, and then I don't know in advance about the number of the student in this class, and then I have known that the first ID will get 100 score, and then the second person will get 99 score, and then and so on, right? And this one will be now, right? At the end of the number of the student, and the last one will get 50. So in this way, how many students in this class? This is 3. And then this one is the data or we call key, right? And this one will be linked. That's why we call linked list. This is another data structure that you have to know, but you will have to study or to learn this in detail next term in the class data structure, right? Normally I will not teach you about the linked list here, but I will teach you next term. But I think you are mature enough to study about the linked list. So I will put the linked list to how to write a programming linked list here, because some of you, right, are really good C programming, in C programming. So maybe you have tried to write a program in order to try to insert into the data structure linked list like this. Linked list is a sequence of data structure, right, which are connected together via the link. Linked list is a sequence of links which contain the item. Item 100, item 99, item 50. Okay, each link contains a connection to another link. This link contains another connection to the other link. A connection to other link. This one will contain, it's not contain any connection to other link, but it is a noun. Okay, now mean N for the linked list. Okay, if you want to try to implement this one, you can use the program, or you can try to write a program in the page 30, 38, 39, and 40. Okay, I have 4 pages for the implementation of the linked list, but I will add them a bit. Add more and more, right? Okay, so but today is I think it's quite late, right? If I'm trying to explain about the linked list, so maybe next week I will teach you again more in details about the linked list. But if you have time this week, right, you can try to write a program, try to copy this and try to see the program implement execution. Okay, and once again, right, there are 70 students here. I want to announce you again, right, because this coming Thursday and Friday it will be the public holiday in Thailand. Okay, actually it is the special day on Thursday, and the compensation day will be the Friday as well. I don't know why. So we are not going to have the lab class on this coming Friday, but PTA, Pitam, my TA, I'm not sure whether he is now in this Zoom or not.
I'm in this Zoom, ครับผม.
Okay, so he is going to tell you about the lab, right, or not?